Good afternoon, YouTube. My little FCAW welder crapped out on me last night. And so I opened her up. This is the over temperature sensor. Slides in there and actually touches on the secondary transformer coils. And the connections on the one side, the tab had rusted to the point where I'm guessing it cracked and then started arcing. So before I get into trying to order a new part, I'm going to see if this is even if this part is repairable. Okay. At normal temperature, it conducts. It does not look in bad shape, other than the fact that that one tab was rusted out and melted from arcing. So we're going to try to repair this, see if we can do an at-home repair. And pause the camera while I get some materials out. Okay, so the first thing we're going to have to do, where are we here, is drill out that rivet. So the rivet's drilled. Now we're going to have to grind this flange back a little bit so that we can run a bolt up in there. We need to figure out how to have a bolt to replace it. And we do, sort of. It's a little on the long side. So we have two wires coming into the transformer that need to connect to spade terminals like this. So we're going to start by installing a spade terminal on one side. This is actually just a piece of ground wire out of a piece of household 240 volt wire. So there's our two spade connectors. Those need to go to a little ring connector. Come on, fingers, work for me here. We just cut part of the shielding off the back of the ring connector. I need to find a washer to put on that before we put the nut on. I'll be back in a second. Okay, so we found a washer, found a screwdriver. This is an interference fit nut. So it's very hard to get started. I think we'll look for a socket. I'm going to look around and see if I have a 440 nut that is not interference fit. Okay, luckily my box of computer screws, I had one that's the right size. We have a storm rolling in. I don't know if you can hear the thunder in the background, but it is making it so humid. Now that's way too long of a is shorter. Okay. Those wires back on that side. Whatever that And they used aluminum wire in this in a welder. Tell this was not North American made. Where did I put the other little? There it is. Okay, so this is not the proper tape for the job, but it's the best quality electrical tape that I have. So we're going to tape up these joints. The over temperature sensor in this, and I looked them up online. The temperature sensor is also used in clothes dryers. So if you have a MIG welder and you're scrapping a clothes dryer, might be worthwhile salvaging the over temperature switches out of it. And as far as I can tell, this is exactly the same arc welder as Harbor Freight sells. Princess Auto doesn't publish the schematics, but Harbor Freight does. Harbor Freight's is made by Chicago Electric. And every photograph of it inside and out looks identical except for the front panel. So we're just going to, we have spark again. So it's just a matter now of putting the screws back in and putting it back into service. So I hope this helped someone out. half tempted to put a cooling fan in it while I have it apart here, but there's an overhang at the front, that's why I couldn't figure out which way it went on. We'll continue putting this back together, and if my next video is a welding video, you know it worked. That's it for now, and thanks for watching.